You ever feel bored playing modern RPG games with repetitive, stat-dependent combat? Do you miss playing games that didn't feel the need to hold your hand throughout the entire experience, making you feel like a baby? Are you a screaming old man telling all your pals that modern video games are just too easy? Well, Exanima might just be the game for you. Exanima is a gothic, dark, medieval-style RPG developed by Bare Mettle in which you explore dungeons, uncover mysteries, and of course, fight complex and smart enemies in a fully interactive world with impressive physics. As soon as you hit new game, you're introduced to a pretty bare-bones character customization screen, with the same hair options for both boys and girls, but at least the weight slider is pretty cool. You awaken in a dark room with a torch next to you and the game begins. You flail around the room, checking your surroundings as you begin your adventure, and this is where my first issue arises. Now, I'm not one to demand a game to hold my hand and give me a long, extensive tutorial on all the game's mechanics or anything. However, would a short tutorial on the controls and how the game works have been too much to ask? Do what Dark Souls does and just have hints on the floor or something. There's a balance between hand-holding and leaving your players completely in the dark, and when you have to look up a video on how your game's combat and movement works because there is no tutorial, it kinda blows. Anyway, immediately the player is immersed in this highly detailed gothic dungeon with excellent lighting and a nice dark atmosphere. The music is admittedly a little cheesy for me, but the ambient sound effects are stellar. So I usually mute the music and just leave the sound effects playing because it honestly makes the game much more immersive. The movement in this game is really awkward. It takes a minute to get used to, but essentially the mouse is your best friend. It controls the character, the environments, combat, and pretty much everything that isn't a menu. The combat is going to be the biggest decider as to whether or not you like this game, but honestly, in my opinion, the combat in this game is incredibly well done and very refreshing compared to how modern games do it now. It is very challenging to get used to and requires a lot of thought and forward thinking. Plus, it adds to the comedy of the game if you're bad at it like me, because it just looks like two drunk dudes are fighting.
Come here, you motherfucker! Come here, you motherfucker!
This game does not fuck around, and you really need to be on your toes. Most modern RPGs are so stat-reliant or button-mashy, but here comes a game that's combat outcomes depend entirely on how good you are at the game, which is awesome. It does take some getting used to though, but I feel like it's a great and extremely rewarding system. The physics engine in this game is extremely impressive. Little things like tripping over objects on the floor or how objects interact with each other is really neat to see. It adds a new element of immersion in ways that most games don't even think of or attempt. I didn't touch the arena mode all that much, mostly because I was more interested in the main story of the game, but what I did play I found very fun, and arena is a great way to learn the combat. I like management sims, and I think with a little more depth, the arena mode can be a fantastic addition to this game. From what I personally encountered, this game doesn't seem to have that many bugs. I did run into one after I died that caused the game to crash, but nothing super awful. What does have me concerned is how often this game is updated. The last time this game was updated was July 10th, 2018. Because we're currently in the year of 2019, that doesn't seem too awful, right? But check this out. The last update before that was February of 2017. Over a year with no new content or communication from the team. There is no consistency when it comes to updates with this game. New updates are released sometimes weekly, or every 6 months, or just once a year. This game has incredible potential, and I'd hate to see it stuck in early access limbo until it fades into obscurity. As far as we know, the game is very actively in development, but it has an extremely slow development. The game initially released back in 2015, and I understand that these things do take time, but man, people are beginning to get impatient. Bare Mettle's Exanima brings us a dark, gritty, unforgiving, and refreshing RPG game with a deeply rewarding combat system and a gloomy and hopeless atmosphere. Its punishing mechanics and different approach to RPG tropes can be somewhat off-putting, but with some practice, the game feels deeply satisfying to play. The inconsistency of updates from the devs can be seen as quite worrisome, and I am afraid that this game may be abandoned because of its scope. But I have no doubt in my mind that if this game ever sees the light of day as a finished product, it will surely be another sleeper hit just like Dark Souls. As it stands right now, though, I would say that this early access title warrants a purchase to support development, but I'd be very wary of this game ever seeing the light of day. As much as it pains me to say, I highly doubt this game will be released as a fully fleshed out game within the next few years. So, if you're patient enough, then I'd say that Exanima is totally worth the money, and this game has the potential to be a PC gaming classic.